And now we turn to the next leg of the Pope's trip and the anticipation and security surrounding his time in New York City. He landed late this afternoon at Kennedy International Airport, where a crowd greeted him. He took a helicopter to Wall Street, and then he headed towards St. Patrick's Cathedral. Hari Sreenivasan was one of those outside when I spoke to him a short time ago. Hari, I see you're front and center there in front of St. Patrick's Cathedral. Tell me, what's the security like in the city? The city shuts down when anybody comes to town, but with the Pope, it must be something.
That's right. Imagine a Super Bowl, multiply that by four, and then put it in downtown Manhattan for a period of 2.5 days or so. I mean, this area, up and down Fifth Avenue, if anybody's been to New York, they've probably been to Rockefeller Center. There's no traffic on here. They've closed it for several blocks in either direction from St. Patrick's. There's a place where he's going to rest overnight. That has security around it. There's obviously Central Park that's preparing. And then tomorrow, he's got four different places that he's going to in the city. As soon as he wakes up, it's kind of a nonstop schedule for him. And everywhere he goes, there has to be this level of security that goes with him, ahead of him.
We saw a little bit of this here in Washington, but it's nothing like what you're going to see there. So give us a thumbnail sketch of his schedule, where he's expected to go and be.
Yeah, for a man his age, it's pretty impressive. After he does Vespers tonight, which is not a mass, but a church service tonight with clergy inside here, then he goes to rest tonight. Tomorrow morning, as soon as he wakes up, he goes to, you know, today he was trying to address the nation of the United States through its representative. Tomorrow he tries to address the entire world at the UN. And after that, he goes to the 9/11 memorial, where he has an opportunity to pray and lead people in a kind of a multi-faith service, if you will. From there, he goes to a school in Harlem, and then he conducts a very small mass at Madison Square Garden. So four areas of the city that have to prepare for him. And, you know, they are actually encouraging people in New York, if you can telecommute tomorrow, do so.
They encourage people about that here in Washington as well, but that didn't dampen the enthusiasm, except with one extra detail, I gather. There are people actually scalping free tickets to see the Pope.
Yeah, that's right. I don't think the Pope or the Cardinals or anyone that cares about the poor is very happy about this. But yes, there were free tickets that were handed out for the event that he's going to have in Central Park. And sure enough, on eBay and on Craigslist, you can start to see these tickets pop up for hundreds of dollars. And you can't prevent the sale from happening, but you can certainly strongly discourage it.
And finally, Hari, that crowd that we're seeing behind you, how long would you say they've all been there waiting for this moment?
So the press was corralled together in this sort of higher security area for several hours, and the people on either side of me in front of the church have been here several hours as well. But what you can't see is the people that are up and down Fifth Avenue on both sides, just waiting for a glimpse of the Popemobile. Perhaps he's going to wave. You know, perhaps he gets out and takes a selfie with them. I don't know. But the people here are just as excited as they were in D.C.
Well, it's amazing to watch from city to city to city this thing unfold. Hari Sreenivasan, thanks a lot.
Thank you, Gwen.